read more scripture than normal. Daniel chapter number 3, the book of Daniel chapter number 3, the great prophetic book of Daniel, one of the greatest prophetic books in the entire Bible. You'll never make sense out of the book of Revelation till you get something in Daniel and vice versa. So we're going to look at a story here in Daniel chapter 3 tonight. These stories literally took place. Daniel was a real person. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were real people. These stories literally took place. They are prophetic over things that will be coming again during the Great Tribulation and before and after. So the kingdom in chapter 2, the lion's den, the whole bit is prophetic also. Tonight, we're going to look at the story in Daniel chapter 3. So I want you to look at your Bible because I'm going to do more extensive reading than I normally do. So bear with me a little bit tonight. All right? I'm going to preach tonight on the subject, walking in the fire. Walking in the fire. Daniel 3, verse 1. Nebuchadnezzar, this great, the king, made an image of gold. That's a picture and type of the Antichrist in the tribulation period, who's going to make an image of the beast that people will worship. Plain as day. Look at the three sixes connected with it, whose height was 60 cubits. There's one, 60. And the breadth thereof, 6 cubits. There's two. And he set it up in the plain of Dura in the province of Babylon. Then Nebuchadnezzar the king sent together the princes, the governors, the captains, the judges, everybody, the treasurers, the counselors, the sheriffs, and all the rulers of the provinces to come to the dedication of the image which Nebuchadnezzar the king had set up. Then they all come together. Now, verse number 4, then an herald cried aloud, to you it is commanded. It was no longer optional. Now that's the way the mark will be when it comes out. It'll be optional at first and then eventually mandatory. You don't have to do it to start with, and then an emergency is going to happen and everybody will have to do it. The chip, the mark in the hand, the whole bit. He said, and herald, it is commanded, O peoples, nations, and languages. Now here comes your third six. Here it goes. It's connected with music. You kids, you want to know what music does? You want to know what's ahead of Eminem and Jay-Z and Kanye and Drake and Beyonce and all the rest? Look at here. It's in your Bible before them people's ever born. They don't even realize what they're doing. Look at it here in verse number 5. That at what time you hear the sound of the cornet, flute, harp, sackbut, psaltery, dulcimer, and all kinds of music. Notice the Old Testament, Old English spelling with the K on it. Nothing wrong with that. You fall down and worship the golden image that Nebuchadnezzar the king has set up. Capital punishment if you don't. And whoso falleth not down and worshipeth shall the same hour be cast into the midst of a burning fiery furnace. Stop right there. Hold your finger. Now think about that. It got to the point where this great big image was set up, and he said, it's no longer optional. You bow and worship. And you know what we're going to do to get you to bow? We're going to play music. You think music's not powerful? It's used to break your will. The devil knows that, and the people that run restaurants know that, and the people that run the nightclubs know that, and the people that make the successful rock and roll CDs and country, and they know music will break down your will. I was somewhere the other day, hold your finger there, car wash, wash my car for yesterday. I can't stand to have a dirty car on Sunday. And I went to the car wash yesterday evening, and there's a lady over there, female, and over there cleaning up a car, and I could hear it. Boom, 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 boom. room, and I could hear the words were bad. Them words and music were saying the same thing too. And buddy, I just like you could feel evil in the presence of that car wash. People say, "Well, I don't feel it." You're either lying or there's something on your feeler. You could feel the devil around that place. And I was in a store. Music changes the whole atmosphere and mood of a place just like that. And I don't know how they did it, but when that music started playing, people who would not have otherwise bowed. Their knees buckled. I know people that have done something extremely against their moral upbringing, listening to music. I know people that have gotten fights, listening to music. It breaks your resistance. And that's what the Bible said they did here with the music. Think about that. Think about it, folks. That's no accident that's in the Bible as a picture of the tribulation. That's not an accident. That's prophetic. Now look at verse number 8. "Wherefore at that time certain Chaldeans came near and accused the Jews." That's not an accident either. All the way through the Bible, Satan been against those Jews. Hitler, all the way through there, exterminate the Jews. The world leaders tonight are talking about Palestinian-Israeli conflict. Palestinian-Israeli conflict. This is not in the message. I'll throw it in for free. God gave every bit of that land over there to Abraham's children, Isaac, Jacob. Not through Ishmael. That land does not belong to the Muslims and the children of Ishmael. It belongs to the children of Abraham through Isaac. Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. That word Jacob, of course, being changed to Israel. Now, let's continue reading. Verse number 14. "Nebuchadnezzar spake and said," they brought these guys. Let's go back and get verse number 12. I'm sorry. Look at verse 12. "There are certain Jews whom thou hast set over the affairs of the province of Babylon, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. These men, O king, have not regarded thee." They're lawbreakers. They told on them. They're breaking the law. They're trying to get them in trouble. "They have not regarded thy gods, nor worshiped the golden image which thou hast set up." They won't go along with the UN. They won't go along with martial law that they had instituted here. They will not bow down to the king's image. Therefore, let's see what we're going to do with them. Verse number 14. "Nebuchadnezzar spake and said, Is it true, O Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, do not ye serve my gods, nor worship the golden image which I've set up?" Now, he's going to give them one more chance. "Now, if ye be ready, at what time ye hear the sound of the cornet, flute, harp, sackbut, psaltery, dulcimer, and all kinds of music, ye fall down and worship the image which I have made, well, I'll let you off the hook. But if ye worship not, ye shall be cast the same hour into the midst of a burning, fiery furnace. And who is that God that shall deliver you out of my hand?" Here we go. Verse 16. "Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered and said to the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, we are not careful to answer thee in this matter." Hold your finger there again. This is what I want everybody in our church to do. Have your mind made up. Know what you believe. Know where you stand. They stood before the king. Right over there was a fiery furnace. Right over here was freedom. All they had to do is bow down and worship a false god, and he'd let them go free. And you know what? They didn't say, "Give us a week to pray about it." They didn't say, "Let us go talk it over and have a business meeting." They didn't say, "Let us ask our wives what they think." They didn't say, let us ask our pastor what he thinks. They said, "We ain't careful. We don't have to bat an eye. We don't have to talk it over. We don't know what our answer is." Thank God those men stood like that. That gives me encouragement when I read about others who stood the test like that. And look here what they said. Verse 17, "If it be so, our God whom we serve is able." It ain't got nothing to do with him not being able, buddy. He's able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us out of thine hand, O king. "But if not, be it known to thee, O king, that we will not serve thy gods nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up. Buddy, he got mad. You know what they done? They said, king, we don't have to pray about it. We don't have to read a book. We are not going to bow down. If God delivers us, we ain't going to. And if he don't, we still ain't going to. There's a Christian, buddy. There's somebody stand for the Lord. And ladies and gentlemen, he got mad. He got mad. And look at verse 19. It says at the bottom of it, he commanded the servants that they heat the furnace 7 times hotter than normal. So they turned the heat up of this thing 7 times what it normally would be. Verse 20. And he commanded the men to bind them and cast them into the burning fiery furnace. Let's look and see what happened. 21. Then these men were bound in their coats, their hosen. I don't know what they was doing wearing hosen. And their hat. That was like their stocking legs, socks. And their hats and other garments, and were cast into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. Therefore, because the king's commandment was urgent and the furnace exceeding hot, the flame of the fire slew those men that took up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And these three men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, fell down bound into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. Then Nebuchadnezzar the king was astonished. Old Testament for astonished. That's Old English for astonished. And rose up in haste and spake. So you didn't have to get a new version to figure out what that word meant. You can tell by looking at it. And said unto his counselors, did not we cast 3 men bound into the midst of the fire? They answered and said unto the king, true. Look at this, verse 25. He answered and said, lo, I see 4 men loose. Look at miracles. I see 4. That's a miracle. They're all loose. That's a miracle. They're walking. That's a miracle. In the midst of the fire. That's a miracle. They have no hurt. That's a miracle. And the form of the 4th is like the capital S Son of God. If you have a Bible that does not say the Son of God, you don't have a right Bible. You need to get rid of it and get you a Bible. That's a NIV. That's a New Modern Versions. Ladies and gentlemen, that's been preached all over the world for thousands of years. And now the NIV comes out and tells it really wasn't the Son of God. It was a Son of the Gods. What in the world is that? I'm telling you, that was a pre-incarnate appearance of the Lord Jesus Christ himself. That king knew God had a son. The Old Testament said, what is his name? And what is his son's name? That king knew God had a son. And he said, there he is, walking in the midst of that fire. And Nebuchadnezzar said, get him out of there. Verse number 26, he came and said, get out, come out. And the Bible said they saw the men, verse 27, upon whose bodies, the middle of verse 27, the fire had no power, nor was a hair of their head singed. Good night. Neither were their coats changed, nor the smell of fire passed on them. Then Nebuchadnezzar spake and said, blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that sent his angel and delivered his servant that trusted in him, and have changed the king's word and yielded their bodies that they might not serve nor worship any god except their own God. Therefore I make a decree. Look at the decree he made, that every people, nation, language, and which speak anything against the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, there shall be cut in pieces, and their houses shall be made a dunghill. They don't translate that one into the natural updated version. Because there is no other God that can deliver after this sort. Then the king promoted Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the province of Babylon, walking in the fire. I've told you the story, so I'm just going to make 3 observations quickly about this story here tonight. Maybe you find yourself walking in the fire. Now, I'm not talking about always literal fire. Sometimes you go through fire, the fire of trial, losing your job, a bout with cancer, divorce, all of these things. Are God's children walking in the fire? Sometimes it winds up literal fire, as it wound up for millions of people, thousands upon thousands of martyrs down through church history. Many times we are called to be walking in the fire as a testimony to the world that our God is able to deliver us. He may not save us from ever going in it, but if we do go in it, He'll be there with us. I've been through enough to know that He's going to take care of me. I've been through the fire a few times, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm glad to say, thank God, never have been through it one time that He didn't walk through there with me. He always shows up. He always takes care of you, and He always will go with you as you're walking through the fire. Let me tell you three or four things right quick. Number one, the demands made on the children of God. They were demands to receive man's religion. Now, it became mandatory. They said, look, you got to start believing like we believe. Now, notice they never stopped them from worshiping their God to start with. They just said, you got to worship ours. They didn't say you've got to get rid of your religion, just incorporate ours into yours. They never told them, you can't worship your God no more. Now, and over there, two chapters later, they made a law that nobody could pray to any other God to get Daniel in trouble, and that was different. But this one, they never said nothing about them forsaking their religion. They just said, you got to bow. Ecumenicalism. That's everybody get together and worship the same. Everybody believe the same. Everybody get together. One world church, one world religion. Ladies and gentlemen, it's just unbelievable what's going on now. I don't know if you've heard of this, the movement that's taking place right now. I'm going to, Lord willing, this summer, after the youth rally, I'm going to bring you a few Sunday nights, and we're going to study the emergent church, if it's God's will. How many of you are familiar with the term the emergent church or the emerging church? Well, you're fixing to be, because it's hitting Christianity, taking it by storm. It's in the Christian bookstores. It's everywhere, and they're talking about this emergence. And this emergence is basically New Age thought, incorporating you, walking a labyrinth, labyrinth. How many of y'all know what walking a labyrinth is? Well, you know, that old stupid thing over yonder in Rome and other places where you walk around in a circle and it's supposed to be a prayer, maybe you feel God's presence, just a bunch of fool stuff like that incorporated into Christianity. There's a lot of well-known pastors of mega churches in this country that are a part of what's called the emerging church. And it's new Bible, new music, new way of worship, and they're even saying now that there could be more than one way. That Shack stuff, that movie, The Shack, all that stuff teaches that junk like that, that Jesus is the best way to heaven. Jesus is simply the best way to heaven. Do I need to say it here? He ain't the best way. He's the only way. Well, the emergent church is saying that we're having a 500-year rummage sale. And they believe that in 1500, when Martin Luther and them began to preach, that was the Reformation, and Martin Luther and them come out of the Catholic Church, and their theme was, or their slogan was, sola scriptura, scriptura sola. Now that means scripture only. Only scripture. And they all said it. Sola scriptura, scriptura sola. Scripture only, only scripture. And I've got it on video where they're now saying that don't work anymore. They said that was good for the last 500 years, but now we need another authority, and it's every bit trying to get all the churches to go back to Rome and go right back under the head of that Catholic Church. And don't you fall for this baloney. Listen, you can go to the Christian bookstore down here in Hickory. You can go to some of them down here in other places, and you see books that are pro-Catholic, even books in some on Christian websites advertising the Eucharist, which is blasphemy, brother. That's not a Christian practice. The priest believes when he blesses that bread and wine that it turns into the literal body of Jesus Christ and his literal blood, and that people are drinking. That's blasphemy. There's no way a Christian can do that. And they will not sell the books by Gail Riplinger or by Chick Publications that endorse the King James Bible. I'm telling you, we're headed into a movement in this country. I'll be naming names. I'll be giving you. You know why? Because you need to be informed. The emergent church is wicked and going against God and what that Bible says. And that's what they did here. They all got together. They all got together. Our belief here at this church is sola scriptura and scriptura sola, amen. Scripture only, only scripture. We still believe the Bible is the final authority in all matters of faith and practice. Just because the world don't understand it and don't like it means nothing. But that's what they done here. They said you all got to bow down. They were demanded to include man's religion with God's truth. That's what they done. They are commanded to back the program. They go along with it. Conform. Don't be a radical. Why do you have to rebel? Why do you have to always be against everything? Just go along with everybody else. Come on. Come on, Shadrach, Meshach. Look at all these thousands of people doing it. Why do you? Listen, sometimes you feel like you're all alone. Sometimes you feel like you're this one person and everybody you know and everybody at work and everybody. Listen, brother, it's always been that way. It was that day way in Noah's day. It was that way in Lot's day. It was that day in the days of the apostles. It was that day in Daniel's day. It was Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and the whole crowd was bound down and said, oh my goodness, why do you have to be so radical? Why do you have to be so fanatical? Just bow down, man. It ain't going to kill you. God knows your heart. He knows you love him. Bow down anyway. They said, nope, nope. No, our Old Testament said, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God. Him only shalt thou serve. We're not to bow down to any. That's your problem. You take it too literal. God understands. He loves everybody. Why do you think you're right and all these people are wrong? Listen, that's coming for us one of these days. It's coming for us. The demands made on the children of God. Number two, the decisions made by the children of God. The decisions made by the children of God. Against the religious opinion, against the world, you have to stand against what your boss man believes and says. You'll have to be the weirdo at work. You'll have to be the one that sticks out. You'll have to be the one that the old sore thumb. You'll have to be the old party pooper. You'll have to be the old plain Jane. You'll have to be the only one. And you know what? You got a lot of Christians now, they're just not willing to be different at work. You want to blend in. Why would you want to blend in with a bunch of reprobates that don't even love the Lord to start with and spit on his word and not bother them one bit? I'm telling you, brother, listen, I made up my mind a long time ago. It don't matter what that people out there think about me. I get my feelings hurt when I go into a place and everybody's laughing and talking and they all look at me like they just turn red. I get my feelings hurt when I walk by sometimes preachers and they deliberately turn their head to keep from speaking to me. That hurts my feelings. But I'm going to tell you one thing, buddy. I'm going to try my best to stay right with God and know when I lay down at night, my heart is clear and clean with him. And brother, if they want to go that way, that's their business. We don't have to be popular with this world. Something wrong with you if you are. Well, unto the man that all speak well of. There's something wrong with this generation of weird churches we got coming up. No repentance, no conviction. Never, I challenge anybody here, bring me a CD or a tape of these mega churches where somebody preached a whole sermon on hellfire. Bring it, I want to hear it. Or anything doctrinal. Or anything about the second coming, the advent. You know why all this dominion theology is being preached? Dominion, and we take dominion. Because them nuts don't believe in the millennium, and they think spiritually we are reigning now with Christ. It does make a difference what you believe. It does make a difference how you look at this book. It does make a difference rightly dividing the word of truth, the decisions made by the children of God. I'm glad I got my feet planted right way back yonder in my early days when I was a teenager and I heard the truth and the truth got down in my heart and it's still true today. Thank God. may wind up with a handful, buddy, but the truth will stand when the world's on fire. A decision was made. They didn't bargain with God. They didn't say, Lord, if you'll deliver us, we'll stand for you. They didn't say, Lord, now, you ain't going to let us go in that fire, are you? If you do, I think I'll just go join them if you ain't going to take no better. What kind of a God? You know, that's the way people are now. I met Christians that say, what kind of God would let my kid get sick? Or what kind of God would let my family break it? Listen, don't blame all that stuff on God. He's crazy. Do you know why there's atheists? Do you know why there are atheists? The reason there's atheists, they know good and well everything can't come out of nothing. But they can't believe in God because they can't bring themselves to accept the fact that there's so much messed up stuff in the world. They say if there was a God, he wouldn't have made a mess like this. They don't realize that the world's under a curse and that sin has caused the world. Listen, they I don't know if I can explain this to you, but they don't believe in God for the same reason we do. It's just two different ways of looking at it. The reason we believe in God, we say, all this couldn't be without a God. And they look at it and say, there's no way God could have done something like this. He did do it. Then man fell. Then the curse came. That's why they're suffering. That's why there's stuff happened over here like happened this week. That little child, a few miles from here. That's why there's people getting their heads cut off in other countries. That's why, because of the curse of sin. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, this world not a playground. This world ain't a place just to live it up and have fun. Thank God we can have some joy and happiness. But I'm telling you, this world is a hell hole on its way to destruction that God's going to burn one day. Amen. The decisions made by the children of God. No ifs, ands, buts about it. They said, you want to bow down? No. Well, don't you want to pray about it? You look to see how hot that fire is? No, we're not going to. Now look, God's able to deliver us. And he's able to deliver us. He will get us out of your hand one way or the other, big boy. But he said, if he don't, we still ain't bowing down. Now, I don't know about you, but I think all of us need to be praying. If that day ever comes, and it might, that God will give us the grace to stand for him. It might. If I don't see it in my lifetime, some of you kids are going to see it to where it is against the law to believe what they're already pushing for it. It's going to be a crime to tell somebody they're lost and going to hell because that's hate speech. That's what's coming down the road. I may not see it, but some of you and your kids will if the Lord don't come. I'm telling you, I'm prophesying you for the word of God. I'm not a prophet. I don't have no special gift, but this book prophesies of that. It's coming. It's coming. Why do you think this story's in the Bible? Why do you think God put that in the Bible? It's coming again. It's coming again. It's coming again. The decision's made by, I've been praying, Lord, if it ever comes my turn, God, give me grace. If I ever got to read about them martyrs and I listen to them and I say, God, they had the guts, they had the faith. God, give it to us. Is what you believe real? Is it real to you? Is your Christianity a game? If you can't even give up one dirty TV show a week to serve God and read the Bible and pray, you'll never stand for God when it really gets bad. You'll never stand for the Lord. Can't push that plate back one meal, you'll not stand when it really gets bad. If you run with the footman and they wear, what do you do when horses come? The decision made by the children of God. Number three, the deliverance made of the children of God. Notice their trials burned away their bonds. Their trials burned away their bonds. I like that. Every preacher says it. All that fire burned off of them was what the world put on them. See, they brought them over here like this, and they tied them boys up like that, and they said, take them away. And they heated up seven times hotter. I don't know what it was. Lord have mercy. It was so hot that it killed the guys who threw them in. Now, you can preach on that all day long. You watch people that try to fight Christians. Watch people that go after preachers. Watch people that try to hurt God's people. It wound up burning them up. Shadrach and Abednego come out real good. But them guys got burned up, the one that's trying to hurt them. You don't have to worry about God taking up for his youngins, buddy. He'll do it. It might look like he's forsaking you, but he ain't. He's just letting you go through the trials. Woo! Thank God! The Lord will take care of you! Lord have mercy, I'm telling you. It burned them fellas up. That threw them in. It burns away the pride. When God puts you in the fire, it'll burn your pride away. It'll burn your self-righteousness away. It'll burn your jealousy away. It'll burn your lust away. It'll burn your self-pity away. Listen, if you ever been in the fire just right, it'll burn everything this world put on you. You know why God lets you go through hard times? Get sin out of your life. If you ain't too stubborn and proud to understand that. But if you get to hurting real bad, you'll start confessing up. Amen? Burned everything the world put on them. Hallelujah. They like to criticize Christians, but they couldn't take it. They like to talk bad about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and they couldn't take it. It killed them. They didn't even go in. A lot of people like to criticize God's people. They could never go through what some of God's people gone through. Never, ever, ever. Amen. I'm telling you something, brother. Their trial revealed the presence of Jesus. Can you hear me? Their trial revealed the presence of Jesus. They didn't see Jesus till they got in that fire. While everything's out here all right, boy, I'm glad them boys didn't bow. I like that song. They didn't bend, they didn't bow, they didn't burn. I used to hear that song. That's a good song, man. They didn't bend, they didn't bow, they didn't burn. I like the song in the songbook that said, three Hebrew children to the flames were thrown. Because a mortal king they would not own. Jesus delivered and the king then saw. Prayer bells of heaven beat a man-made law. I like that prayer. That's in your songbook. And buddy, there's over there like this. And they looked around. Shadrach said, I believe he's delivering us. No, I'm telling you, this fire, it's going to get us. I'm telling you, man, something's around us. And they looked around and said, who's that? And they said, there's the Lord. And they were walking around saying, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. And the king was over here, and these dead men laying here beside the furnace. And the king said, oh, good night. Oh, Lord. Oh, my goodness. Look, how many did we throw in there? They said three. He went, one, two, three, four. He said, there's four of them in there. What in the world's going on? And he said, get them out of there, Shadrach. And he said, well, I ain't coming out. We're in here fellowshipping with Jesus. I mean, I never felt better in my life. Cool the temperature. There's air conditioning on in here. King, glory to God, he's real. And I'm going to tell you tonight, I'd rather be in the fire with him and with his presence than to have this world's good and know Jesus. Listen, people. You know what we got to have here, Shining Light? We just got to have Jesus in here. Amen. We may not be the richest. We may not be the best looking. We may not be the most talented. But I tell you what, we can have him in here. And if we got him in here, that's all that matters. Glory to God. Hallelujah. There's just so much in this, I could never get to it. Finally, the decree made for the children of God. They were decreed to be God's men. He said, them guys are right. And that's what's going to happen again. Eventually, at the end of the tribulation, they're going to say, you know what, them people were right. You know what happened in Noah's day? When that rain started falling, they said, them guys, well, he was right. You know what happened in Lot's day? Lot got his daughters left, and his wife turned around, remember? Look back to Philippi. Them people in Sodom said, he was right. His sons-in-law that mocked, thought he mocked, they said he was right. And that's what the king said. You know what them people, they always figure out they were right after it's too late. And they pull, you know when people's going to figure out Christians are right? When it's too late. If I was you, I'd take it by faith, young people, tonight. And say, I'll stake my very life that he's going to take care of me. I have put my life. My mind's made up. By his grace, I'm going to do just what I'm doing till I die or he takes me out. If by God's grace, I'm not boasting. I can't do that in myself. I ain't strong enough. But by God's grace, that's what my mind's made up. I ain't wanting to join nothing else. I ain't wanting to go find out something else to bow down to. I know it's some new age foolish junk like that. And they say, well, you can meditate and you got to find your third eye. And they're even bringing yoga, Christian yoga. Have y'all heard about that? Christian yoga. Don't be like that, girls. You can exercise all you want to without getting into Eastern Hindu religion junk. Yoga is Hindu religion. Eastern is a bunch of junk. No such thing as Christian yoga. That's like Christian rap, Christian rock, Christian homosexual, Christian murder. There ain't no such thing. You cannot incorporate yoga into Christianity. That Saddleback Church out there, everybody's talking about it in the whole United States, check it out. Having yoga classes. There are guys going around teaching Christian yoga. Listen, when you sit around and do like this, cross your legs and start doing stuff like that, that ain't exercise. Do some jumping jacks. Touch your toes. I can touch my toes. Do some push-ups. Brother, do some push-ups. You ain't going to get into Eastern mysticism doing that. That's sweat. That's good for you. Listen, I'm not looking for something else to believe in and join. The decree made for the children of God. Bible said it came to pass. I like it. I like that song somebody made. It's a sort of a play on words. It came to pass. No matter what you're going through, it didn't come to stay. It come to pass. It come to pass. The other song is, God will make this trial a blessing, though it brings me to my knees. Gosh. Man, I'm emotional tonight because thoughts run back from my mind for 35 years. God will make this trial a blessing, though it sends me to my knees. Woo! I thank him for every valley. I thank him for every trial. I thank him for every time I've been in the fire. It'll make you a better person. It'll make you a sweeter Christian. It'll make you more dependent on him. The decree made for the children of God. They decreed God should be worshipped. Them guys, buddy, they stood the test. You know what? Them people done Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego a favor without even realizing. They threw them in that fire. I bet Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego come out, and the king said, all right, everybody got to worship their God. And said, God bless you, man. That's the best experience I ever had in my life. It wasn't fun to start with, and I was scared, but when Jesus showed up, that made it worth it all. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Listen, he done them a favor. We'd have never heard of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego if that hadn't happened. It's been preached all over the world a million times. God made that trial a blessing. You know what? I don't know what kind of fire you're walking through tonight. But God will make it a blessing. If you'll make up your mind, I'm going to trust you. I will not bow down to them other gods. Amen. Let's stand by our head for prayer. Come on, Miss Desi.